Bonjour! Aujourd'hui, nous allons voir les questions, partie 1, OK? Voyons voir ici les petits dessins. Donc ici, nous avons, OK, the person is asking, or is saying, tu parles français. So, I want you to see the difference. So, this one says, tu parles français. Ici, tu parles français? Oui! Ici, tu parles français, n'est-ce pas? Oui! OK, so, depending on how you do your intonation in French, that could mean a big difference between like a simple statement and a question. So, it's very important that you use the proper intonation if you want to ask questions in French, OK? Because here, it's not even a question. So, if you just say that, tu parles français, the other person is going to look at you like, yeah, what? So, it's just saying you speak French. This is, do you speak French? And this would be more like, you speak French, don't you? OK? So, we're going to learn how to ask questions in French in four different ways. Mais pour commencer, we're going to see two, OK? The easiest one to start. Premièrement, numéro un. Nous avons l'intonation, OK? So, you can make a question in French just by changing the intonation of your statement. Par exemple, ici, j'ai « il est canadien », OK? If I change that with a question mark at the end and I pronounce it like this, « il est canadien », OK? That becomes a question. It's the difference between « he is Canadian » and « is he Canadian », for example. Donc, « il est canadien », so that's the easiest way to ask a question in French, is to use rising intonation. This is considered a little bit informal, but people use it all the time. Maintenant, vous avez aussi l'expression « n'est-ce pas ?»« N'est-ce pas ?» Vous pouvez répéter « n'est-ce pas ?» OK? If you add that at the end of your statement, that becomes a tag question, okay? So, for once, French is going to be a lot more simple than English, okay? Because when we learn English, when it's not your first language, those tag questions are a big nightmare, okay? Because you have so many combinations, isn't it, aren't you, don't they, etc., etc., I don't know how many you have. In French, we have one, okay? So, n'est-ce pas will replace, aren't you, don't you, will they, are we, etc., etc., okay? You just have to know how to spell it and how to say it, n'est-ce pas, okay? So, if I want to say, or if I want to ask, she's a student, isn't she, okay? Donc, the only thing I need to do in French, I can add a comma here, elle est étudiante, n'est-ce pas? That's all, OK? Elle est étudiante, n'est-ce pas? And then that usually will trigger yes or no after that. So the person can say oui, elle est étudiante, ou non, elle n'est pas étudiante, OK? In French, we don't usually answer these questions using true, OK? It would sound weird. So you would say either yes or no to that, OK? So, what I would like you to do, OK? Ici, je vous ai mis trois exemples, trois phrases, OK? Three sentences. I would like you to try to do these three sentences and transform them into questions using first intonation and then n'est-ce pas? So, here you can pause, you can practice, and then when you're ready, you can hit play again and I will show you how it's done. OK? Alors, pour l'exemple dans A, tu es Mexicain, OK? Si on veut faire intonation, that's all we need to do. Donc, on dirait, tu es Mexicain, OK? Tu es Mexicain. With n'est-ce pas, on ajoute une virgule et on ajoute n'est-ce pas. Donc, tu es Mexicain, n'est-ce pas? You're Mexican, aren't you? OK? So, très, très simple. B. Ils étudient la chimie, OK? Donc, même chose. Ils étudient la chimie, OK? Are they studying chemistry? Or if you want to ask, they're studying chemistry, aren't they? Donc, ils étudient la chimie, n'est-ce pas? C. Vous travaillez à la bibliothèque. Vous travaillez à la bibliothèque? Are you working at the library? Ou bien, vous travaillez à la bibliothèque, n'est-ce pas? You work at the library, don't you? OK? Donc, c'est très, très facile. Vous avez numéro 1, intonation, et numéro 2, n'est-ce pas? Ça va? So, you can join me in the next part of this video to learn more ways to ask questions in French. Au revoir!